Hello, everyone. It's Saturday, February 22nd in the year of our Lord 2014. Yaman, how are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. It's Cinema Saturday, man. And Woman. And yes, we're featuring one of my favorite movies of all time. Cool Runnings. Feel the rhythm. Feel the ride. Get on up. It's bobsled time. Cool Runnings. Love that movie. Oh, yeah. Leon, Dougie, Doug. Raul D. Lewis. And Malik Yoba and John Candy. Legendary crew. Legendary movie. From 1993. All about the Jamaican bobsled team at the 88 Calgary Olympics. That was a lot of fun. And today's beer, today's show is sponsored to you by our good friends over at Champs Americana Schaumburg, Schaumburg, Illinois. Great food, great people, great times, great sports bar, awesome stuff. And Champs Americana Schaumburg, ugh, great to feature you. Yes, folks, I'm tired, and the reason why I'm tired is because I'm stuffed because I've already had dinner. An incredible dinner. Mama made nachos. Yeah. Chili cheese nachos. From scratch. Well, today's beer of the day, boys, girls, and it's. Thank you, Cameron Franklin, my dear friend. A lovely Jetsicle who I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. She brought me a Boulevard Brewing Company out of Kansas. Boulevard Unfiltered Wheat Beer. Although it's only 4.4%, below average in strength, it is definitely full of flavor. Awesome stuff. Boulevard Brewing Company, and it is out of... Where in Kansas is this from? I can't remember. Thought it was Wichita, but it doesn't say. Boulevard Brewing Company. Proper opening apparatus. Proper technique. Oh, and a good pop mon. Yeah. 45 grand, a random pick, something apparatus, whatever keyboard, because I'm just that damn good. Haven't spilled a drop yet. Never have, never will. Cheers to beers, all of you cross, they say Germany, kapai, they say in Japan. Oh god, that's good. Definitely a triple bell ringer. Awesome. A big A on this one. A for awesome. This is a phenomenal wheat beer. I forgot how good this stuff is. Man, Cameron, you're a sweetheart. You're awesome. And you're a dear friend. Cheers and beers to you, my dear. And hey, let me know what you think of those beers I hooked you up with, huh? It's all about good beer connoisseurs trading beers, you know? Oh, wow. Lots of good Jamaican music today, man. That's right. And how about we bring out another one? Oh, a great remake of a Bob Marley classic. There you go. Steer It Up, Diana King. Hey, music from the movie Cool Runnings. Well, folks, we got a lot of birthdays to get to. Right off the bat, she's a lovely lady, Mafia at, that's right. Mafia Wars player, Carrie Leaf. How you doing? Happy birthday to you. And, she's always helped me out on the old Mafia Wars. Hey, I appreciate it. Help you out as well. It's all about good people helping good people to reach out to other people in our crews so that we can go whack some bad people. Icing fools, you know? Lots of fun. And Carrie, happy birthday to you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list. Oh, another Mafia Wars lady. helped me out all the time as well. Blodwin Jones. Blodwin, happy birthday to you. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope you enjoy this here show. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. By golly, celebrate well and enjoy. And big cheers and beers to you. Hope you enjoy the show. Ooh. I gotta drink two beers, probably. Ooh. This is gonna be a rough one. I am beyond stuffed. Next on the list. Now here's a lovely lady I've known since 1990. The lovely, gorgeous, amazing. I knew her as Stephanie Teixeira. Stephanie Schofield. The proud owner of Wicked Cheesy Pizza. That's right. Her and her man run that place. Her and her husband. And Stephanie, happy birthday to you, Steph. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. You know, I didn't need the Facebook to memorize your birthday. I had everybody's birthday in high school memorized. Remember that? Including you. That's right. Squeeze me. Oh. Steph, you got a wonderful family. Beautiful family. You're beautiful. Look fantastic. And hope you're having a phenomenal time. Hope you're having a phenomenal birthday. And, hey. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you. Hey, pizza and beer. I'm down with that. Do it. Wicked. Wicked cheesy pizza, folks. Look that one up, will ya? I have to make a visit next time I come home on vacation. Next on the list. Another Mafia Wars guy. My man, Paul Padilla. Paul Padilla, P-A-D-I-A. Paul, what's going on? How are you? Hope you're doing well. Always a pleasure playing the Mafia Wars with you. And hope you're having a phenomenal birthday. And brother, celebrate well and enjoy. By God, cheers and beers to you. Next on the list. My man, Mike Buds. Now, I know this guy from Martha's Vineyard Regional High School. He's a fine, outstanding graduate of Martha's Vineyard Regional High School class of 1990. That's right. Yeah, your birthday's today, huh? We'll go with that, brother. We'll go with that. You know, the love doctor knows what the real birthday is. But Mike, happy birthday, Mike Buds. Farm Bureau legend. Great friend of mine. Known the guy for 25 years. Oh, hell, longer than that. And Mike, hope you're doing well. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. I know you're happy about Canada. Hey, Canadian heritage. Nothing wrong with that. Hey, look at the Canadian sunglasses, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Oh, Canada indeed. That's right. Much respect to Canada. Hockey legends. Ugh. Cool Me Down by Tiger. Here we go. Hey, it was 1988 Calgary Olympics. You know, I don't know what the hell I wear in Ottawa Senators hockey jersey. I love Canada. I do. But I'm American, baby. American. Yeah. All right. Well, Mike. Brother. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Celebrate like it's 1969. Minus the acid. Cheers and beers to you, brother. Wow. And the final birthday of the day goes to my man, Bill Posey. Bill, what's going on? How are you? Happy birthday to you. Another Mafia Wars man. Lots of Mafia Wars birthdays today. Hey. February 22nd, hell of a day indeed, huh? Bill, my friend, hope you're enjoying the show. Hope you have a wicked awesome day and celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you. All right. Well, we got a happy anniversary for today. 17 years of wicked awesome marriage. That's awesome. That's wicked awesome. Ryan and his better half, Jamie Zwerneman. Hell yeah. There you go. Happy anniversary to the two of you. Hope you enjoy the show. Hope you have a phenomenal anniversary. May it be the best one yet, eh? I work with Ryan down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as West Louisiana. He fixes weapons for a living. Yeah! Right. Tough guy. There you go. Ryan and Jamie, happy anniversary to the two of you. Hope you enjoy the show. I have to give some love, Dr. Love, to this amazing couple. My dear friends, Jeff and his better half, Maria Fontaine. I've known them since 1993. And what's amazing about Jeff, in particular, him and I would watch this movie at least twice a week. Remember that, Jeff? Come on. In fact, when I came to visit you in Massachusetts for the first time, I had seen you in 18 years. You and your gorgeous, amazing, ageless wonder, better half, Maria. Yeah, you are that gorgeous, Maria. What did Jeff and I do? You bet your ass we watched Cool Running. That's right, brother. You know it. We know the lines. We know them all. I don't want to spoil the show. Because you're going to hear the Jamaican bobsled chant later. That's right. Well, Jeff, Maria, love you guys. Cheers and beers. Hope you enjoy the show. Come on. That's right. All right. And now we had a trivia question. I thought it was pretty easy. And so did this guy to answer it almost immediately. What Winter Olympics was the first one to feature the Jamaican bobsled team? My man Chris Crowley, a comical nav wizard I worked with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Northern Mexico, who's moved on to bigger and better things. Chris nailed it almost immediately. He said 1988 Winter Olympic Games in Calgary, Alberta, Canada. Brother, you friggin' nailed it. Wicked awesome job. Big love to Dr. Salute to you. Yaman! Well done, my friend. Cheers and beers. Wicked awesome job. Yeah. Empty as a brain cell. Average Yankees fan. Yeah, let's go with that. Whew. That beer went down in 12 minutes. Less than that. I'm full. That one filled me up. Oh, well. Another one, I suppose. Could never go wrong with a wild... City Dog Wild Blueberry Wheat Ale. 4.7% of absolute wicked awesomeness. Out of Portland, Maine. Otherwise known as Southern Quebec. Eh? Squeeze me. Power beer opening apparatus. Proper technique. You've seen this one on the show a few times. Oh, what a pop, though. 45 degree, all right, the beer consumption apparatus, right over the keyboard, because I'm that damn good. Haven't spilled a drop yet. Never have, never will, man. Or woe, man. Or eat. Ah. How about some more music, eh? Let's do that. Wailing Souls with Picky Picky Head. Picky Picky Head. An interesting song. Picky Picky Head. Picky Picky Head. Cheers and peace to all of you. Prost, as they say in Germany. Goodbye, as they say in Japan. A plus, all the way, as you all well know. That beer is practically perfection. Well. Let's get to some punks of the day. You gotta start out with Therese Bannon. Therese Bannock himself, Leon. Leon Robinson, by the way, did you want him? He does have a last name. Therese Bannock. The leader and driver of Jamaican bobsled team. Really was a great movie. Hey, on this day in 1732, He passed away December 14th, 1799. You ever heard of George Washington? That's right, the first president of the United States of America. There you go, that's Leon nowadays. How about that? Yeah. Well, George Washington, happy birthday to him. He would be 300. No, he'd be 200, I'm sorry. Yeah, he'd be 282 years old today. Oh, Rashad Rondo! Badass point guard, Boston Celtics. Rajon Rondo, 28 years old today. How about that? Drew Barrymore. Ooh, baby. I always like to call her Drew Barrymore. Yeah. Drew Barrymore, 39 and still looking fine. How about Steve Irwin, the Crocodile Hunter? Born this day, 1962. Sally killed when he was stung by a jellyfish in 2006. Unbelievable. And 44 years old. Love the Crocodile Hunter. Definitely miss him. Look at that. Leon then and now. Dr. J. Legendary dunk specialist. Dr. J. Julius Erving. A legendary basketball player, predominantly with the Philadelphia 76ers, also with the New Jersey Nets of the ABA at the time. He is 64 years old today. Bruce Forsyth, actor, talk show host, or game show host, excuse me. Bruce Forsyth, 86 years old today. How about that? James Blunt, famous for the song You're Beautiful. Love that song, good tune. James Blunt, 40 years old today. Happy milestone birthday to him. Jerry Ryan, 7 of 9, Star Trek, Deep Space Nine. She is so fine. Jerry Ryan, 46 years old today. There you go, Big McLeod, huge. You knew I wasn't going to mess that one up. Hell no. It was Deep Space Nine, I hope. Yeah. Almost doubting myself here. Well, how about some more music, man? Woman, eat. Sweet Jamaica by Tony Rebel. Absolutely. With John Candy. Robert Wadlow was born on this day in 1918. Sadly, passed away in 1940. Only 22 years old. The problem was the fact that he was so tall. Obviously, poor circulation. Now, Robert Wadlow, the tallest person that ever lived. Proven. When he died at the age of 22, he was 8 foot 11. Nearly 9 feet tall. Still the tallest lived person ever. There he is, then and now. Leon Robinson as Doris Bannock. Jamaican bobsledding legend. Ooh, look at her, will ya? Too bad I couldn't find anything else with her. Leon. One more picture of him. Nice fedora. I'm digging that. Looks like my fedora, actually. Pretty cool. Former Senator of Massachusetts Ted Kennedy, born this day in 1932. Sadly passed away in 2009 at the age of 77. Lord Baden-Powell, born this day in 1857, passed away in 1941. Founded the Boy Scouts. How about that? Lady Baden-Powell, born this day in 1889. Oh, he was such a cradle robber. And she passed away in 1977. Ooh. Wow. Well, she was a major force behind the development of the Girl Scouts. Actor Robert Young, Marcus Welby, MD. He was famous for that TV show. Robert Young, born this day in 1907, passed away in 1998, lived to be 91 years old. How about Sheldon Leonard? Sheldon Leonard was born on this day, February 22nd, 1907 as well. He lived until January, I believe it was January 11th of 1997. He lived to be almost 90 years old. Well, we remember him as Nick the Bartender in It's a Wonderful Life. He played a lot of tough guy villains back in the day. And then later on produced The Andy Griffith Show, I Spy. And there was another one that eludes me at the moment. Well, shit. I'll drink. Dick Van Dyke Show. Just remember. Come on. Well, I think it's time we check out some Psycho Coffee. Push Guy Champion. Breakman. I must dive. Psycho Coffee played by Doug E. Doug. Doug E. Doug. Awesome guy right there. Come on. Psycho Coffee. I must dive. All right. How about, oh, love this. Love this song. Rise above it. Lock, Stock, and Barrel. Good message song, I think. That's a problem. I'm freezing this. I'll pay you a dollar to shut up. Whoa! I remember that scene. Right out there he goes, ugh. And then she's all, old lady. Oh, a classic scene. Sparky Anderson, legendary manager of the Detroit Tigers, prior to that, the Cincinnati Reds. I believe first manager to ever win a World Series in both leagues. He was born this day in 1934, sadly passed away in 2010. 76 years old. I know, I've seen that picture a lot, huh? Not a lot of different pictures of Psycho Coffee. Then and now. How about that? I think he should have kept the dreadlocks himself. Ugh. Alright. Vijay Singh, golfer. Fiji Islands, 51 years old today. Actor John Mills, English actor John Mills. Born this day in 1908. Passed away in 2005 at the age of 97. Akira Takasaki. This guy formed the Japanese heavy metal band Loudness. And he is compared to Yngwie Malmsteen as far as wild, fast, badass guitar riffs and stuff. Hell of a guitarist, no doubt about it. 53 years old today. And then Michael Chang, tennis player, American tennis player. Ooh, 42 years old today. Wow, folks. Never good to record with full belly syndrome. Never good at all. No, man. No. Bad. Ah, the favorite chant of the movie. Listen, folks.
Some people say you know them can't believe. Jamaica, we have a bobsled team. We have this Wonder East, Alohan Junior. You, Sanka. The fastest of the fastest of Jamaican sprinters. Go to Olympics, fight for Jamaica.
Come on! Let's show off, here's the good part. Raul D. Lewis. Junior Bevel. Have a coke and a smile.
We now come to the second chance for the four intrepid men from Jamaica. What do they have to do, John?
In reality, Al, I don't think the Jamaicans have any chance of winning a battle.
Dear God, just let it be better than yesterday.
Ready! Ready! Feel the rhythm! Feel the ride!
Get on up! It's bobsled from Guyanese! Junior Bevel, then and now. All right. Wailing soul singing wild, wild life. Raul D. Lewis, Junior Bevel. And of course his dad. I see pride. I see power. I see a badass mother who don't take no crap off of nobody. Gotta show off the big baldy, Yul Brynner. That's right, not the real original Yul Brynner, but hey, it was Yul Brynner and Cool Runnings. What do you want from me, Malik Yoba? How about that beat your butt right now, Pop? How about that draw a line down the middle of your head so it looks like a butt? That's him nowadays, folks. He can grow hair. How about that? Malik Yoba, then and now. Yul Brynner. Look at those glasses. Wow! Why? Who's gonna tell him he can't, right? He'll break you. One more of Yul Brynner and Malik Yoba. Mm-hmm. Sadly, there wasn't much for babe pictures at all. Bertina McCauley, you know, Mrs. Bennick. That's right. Therese Bennick's mom. A girlfriend or something. A wife, I think, actually. I don't remember. All I know is that's the only picture I've ever. That's the only picture I have of her, unfortunately. Yeah, we got two babes in a day, and between them, five pictures. It's kind of sad. Oh, we love this song. I can see clearly now Jimmy Cliff's version, a real classic. Although Johnny Nash's original, I think, was even better. Tough to say, they're both phenomenal. Come on! I can see all obstacles in my way. Ah, Pauline Stone Myrie. Mrs. Coffee! The mom of Sanka Coffee! Gotta love her. Oh yeah, there she is. Shut up, everyone! My boy is on TV! I'll never forget that line. And sadly, that's all I could find of her. Pauline Stone Myrie. It's your babes of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. Gotta give respect to the Mon Erblitza. John Candy, of course. Sadly, his last major role. You know, he made a couple more movies, but had a fatal heart attack March of 1994. Only 43 years old when he died. Well, he was 41, 42 when he filmed this one. John Candy definitely sorely missed. No doubt about it. A very funny man and a phenomenal actor. And no doubt about it, definitely sorely missed. It's hard to believe he's been gone for nearly 20 years now. Unbelievable. Filmed in Jamaica and in Calgary, Alberta, Canada, by the way. And if I could have found any pictures of that lovely Canadian line dancer, Karen J. Scott, I'd have definitely put her up. Because she was hot. Beautiful blonde dancer with Sanka Coffee in the Canadian country bar. There he is. Come on, Jamaica. Okay, I couldn't help but sneak a picture in there of Uncle Buck, you know? And a few other pictures of John Candy that I could find. Oh, Love that hat, as you well know. Uncle Buck in his Ford LTD. Getting all kinds of messages. I'll get it tomorrow, Sarah Milligan. Yeah. Oh, that didn't sound good.
Bling, bling, who's that with Tuba Cat?
They're lying.
That's Black, where my Tuba's at?
I'm tired of
they got my back, but I'm still strapped. Got the real fat, fat track.
Ah!
Ain't no shame in my game, just even the real. You think that I will scoop your girl? Oh, yes, I will.
Sorry, I had to blow my nose.
Tactic, I'm a racket. I make fellas jump up and
run. Oh, gross.
So, bring it round and rosy. I'm smoking, you know me. I'm low-key. I'm smoking like a Sony. There is no way you can see me like Stevie. Wonder how I'm living it.
Remember, it's raw, unedited footage, folks. You know, contrary to the story in the movie, the Jamaican bobsled team was met with open arms by the international bobsledding teams. One of the other teams even went so far as to lend the Jamaican team a backup sled so they could qualify. So yeah, they were actually very much loved the entire time. And they are so popular, I really wish Jamaica would do well in bobsledding. I really do. Maybe someday they'll win that gold medal. Well, hell, just get a medal. That'd be great. They finish in last place this year. Tired man. The crash scene at the end of the movie is actually the real footage taken from the 1988 Winter Olympic Games in Calgary. That did happen. You know, let's get to the final two songs. Country Calypso from Cool Runnings by Hans Zimmer. Gotta have some Hans Zimmer music. In the sport of bobsledding, adding weight to the sled is perfectly legal. Let me show off 50 more pictures of Cool Runnings for the final two songs. And give some movie facts. There wasn't a lot of movie facts, unfortunately. But yeah. So both 2 and 4 man sleds have minimum and maximum weights. The weight of the sled is calculated as the total weight of the sled and its crew. If the fully loaded sled weighs less than the maximum, it is perfectly legal to add weight to make up the difference. It also explains why 4-man bobsled is actually faster than 2-man bobsled. You wouldn't think that, but it is. Weight makes it go faster, man. According to Tommy Swerdlow, the only line in the film that he did not write was, "Senka, you dead?" That is the only line that came from the original version of the script. Wow. "Senka, you dead?" Yeah, man. Now, contrary to the movie, the infamous crash wasn't due to mechanical error, but more or less losing control of the sled at such a high speed. Boy, ain't that the truth? It's like 4 men in a tub. Pretty crazy. Now, what's crazy is Denzel Washington turned down the role of Derice, and Eddie Murphy turned down the role of Sanka. They balked at the pay offered. It's too bad. Although, you know something? I think Dougie, Doug, and Leon did a phenomenal job of this movie. They really did. And the final song. We remember this. The walk home after they crashed. Carrying that bobsled. Although I was reeling, the actual Jamaican bobsled crew pushed it. They pushed it to the finish line, but did finish the race. Therese, you dead? No, man. I'm not dead. I must finish the race. In the German dubbing of this movie, the Swiss bobsledders, you know, the ones that say, Eins, zwei, drei. The lines have been redubbed with a strong Swiss accent. Eins, zwei, drei. When the other characters imitate them, they also imitate the accent. In the original English version, Hochdeutsch, standard German, is spoken. Interesting. Oh, there he is, Kurt. The president. Rise and shine, it's butt whooping time. You know, during the opening ceremony scene, Irv Blitzer is seen wearing a white Smith-built cowboy hat. The white Smith-built is a trademark of the city of Calgary, where the 15th Winter Olympics were held in 1988. That white cowboy hat. That you'll see in a moment. Oh, goody. There it is, the music. Coke is good stuff. Coca-Cola. There you go. Remember him, of course. And of course, this film was indeed based on a true story, as we all know. The film debuted at number 3. The film had domestic earnings of $68,856,263 in the United States and Canada, and $86 million internationally, with $416,771 earned in Jamaica, for a total of $154,856,263 worldwide. There's that trademark Smith-built hat. Cool stuff. I'd like to have one of those. I'd like to have one of them Jamaican hats, too. The bobsled competition in the film consists of 3 individual runs held on consecutive days, whereas in reality, the Olympic bobsled competition is two runs per day over a 2-day period. Why not another picture of that? Awesome stuff. Take a coffee, push guy jumping. I see Junior. Ah, oh, great scene right there. We be jumping. I love Sanka Coffee's outfit. That's great. Wearing everything. Come on. Doesn't mean I like you. There he is. Sanka Coffee. Out of my way. Oh, Dougie Doug was phenomenal in this movie. Mm-hmm. No doubt about it, folks. One of my top 10 favorite movies of all time. Yep, that's right. Dougie Doug. And Cool Runnings. Definitely one of the best. Well, folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Time for you to slam the rest of that there beer, man. I'm pacing myself. Wow. You know what time it is. It's time to make a fetus and head out. So everybody take care of a wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. See, I got that line from Cool Runnings a long, long, long time ago. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive my spirit. Drink or you might kill yourself or somebody else. And drinking and driving is dumber than being a Yankees fan. And what's dumber than that is rooting for puke-infested goober schnitzels like Eli. Oh, I'm as good as Tom Brady. Yeah, you're dreaming, douche. Manning! Or men slapping women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people to watch on bets, or fake friends, or anybody that supports the fans or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church. Things like that are just plain stupid. And definitely deserve a big, fat, GFY. Folks, I'm out of here. I'll see y'all tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Squeeze me. Bye. Yeah, man.